CM Punk. He seems helpless.
Oh, did you see that? His body twisting and turning in a sickening way.
Three.
Now back to the ring. What impact delivered from that toss. And he brings his leg crashing down. Locked and loaded. A battle of wills now. Reversal. Can he follow up? Rolling out of harm's way. Smart strategy there. Oh, there it is.
One. Two.
Back into the ring now. And just tossing him to the ground. Incoming.
The outlook of a match in an instant.
Straight kick right to the head. Nothing fancy about that. And we're going back between the ropes.
I don't like how slow he is to react right now.
Two. Three.
And he's brought back in.
I don't know how he can counter this. I don't know how he's going to get out of this here.
Oh, man. Does that look painful?
This is serious gut check time.
Uh-oh, look at this.
Oh!
Trying to put him away.
What a move by the Soldier.
He could pin his opponent right here.
Whether you like it or not, there's the match right there.
We got a couple of highlights here. Let's check them out. Let's go to the highlights here.
Here is your winner, the Superstar Youngblood, Frank.
Wow, he just never got out of the starting gate.
What an impressive victory that was.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, from parts unknown, the Superstar Youngblood, Frank.
Seth Rollins can come from under the ring or the crowd. I mean, you never know what he's
for Wynn. Well, going to the top, high risk.
That was precision. What a move.
Oh, no. That did it. I mean, there is nothing like seeing somebody go flying through the air. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Another clubbing blow. Doing whatever it takes to win. Extra slow getting back to his base here. And he goes flying. Doing whatever it takes to win.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there.
Doing whatever it takes to win.
Boy, he just got laid out.
Out, buying himself some breathing room.
Do you see this, Cole? Just as important. Do you hear it? Oh, man, so powerful. Two. And the soldier blocks it.
Three.
Oh, man. And that one hit with the force of a big rig.
He drops the elbow.
Two.
Boy, there's no way he's going to be able to stand after that.
Three.
Whoa, I didn't see that coming.
Yeah, that's because Seth Rollins is just so quick.
Oh, did you see that, Cole? Talk about getting your spine adjusted.
Five.
Jeez.
And we're going back between the ropes.
Six.
Seth Rollins' career began as one of the most respected grapplers on the independents.
A few more seconds, and this could end in a countout. Whoa.
He's measuring.
Submission! The hold's locked in! He's wearing him down with a very effective submission hold.
Look out!
That's insane. That's absolutely nuts. One, two, three!
The soldier wins! We got a couple of highlights here. Let's check them out. Let's go to the highlights here.
Here is your winner, the superstar, Youngblood, Frank.
An emotional victory here tonight.
Man, oh man, what a...
This is it. These two superstars will test each other's will to determine who the best competitor is here tonight. Slings. Putting it all on the line. He scored with that one.
I mean, that's how you pick your moment and go for it. Oh, my God. Oh, man. Well, going to the top, high risk.
Wow, how good is this guy?
He's going to take another chance.
Is he fired up?
Doing whatever it takes to win. Whoa, right on target.
You know, Michael, it seems hard to believe that John Cena has held the WWE Championship more than 10 times.
Unreal.
That sounds impossible. I remember the 10th time he won the title, taking it from Alberto Del Rio in Buffalo on the Night of Champions in 2011. That was the kind of a milestone that we might get to witness once in a generation.
And we called the match.
Yes.
By John Cena. And the soldier boxing.
Cena with a textbook counter.
Yeah, you know, I know some people don't want to hear it, but the truth is, John Cena is so technically sound.
You know, we were talking about the incredible way John Cena secured his 10th WWE Championship. The deck was stacked against him on that Night of Champions in 2011.
Yes.
He had to beat Alberto Del Rio, and the Mexican aristocrat had some help. But as he usually does, John Cena dug down deep. He beat the odds, and he claimed the title. Cena was a man possessed that night.
Oh, Cena was possessed, all right, Michael. And he did some repossessing, too. He stole Alberto's car before the match and entered the arena in it. Remember that?
Of course I do.
Cena was really trying to provoke Del Rio, and it worked. Alberto was furious. You don't steal an aristocrat's automobile. You just don't do it.
Two.
And he's heading back inside the ring. Good Lord, look at the fire in his eyes.
He wasted no time going
ahead. John Cena is still going.
After all of these shots to the head, I've got a feeling that Soup's going to be on his diet for the foreseeable future. He's heading back up. Every time he has to get up, it takes more and more effort.
Something in his eye.
John Cena with the offense. Man. Oh.
John Cena imposes his will.
He's measuring, and that should do it. He's begging for it.
Are we gonna see it, Cole?
I think so.
The soldier with thunderous impact. His shoulders are down. Two, three.
The soldier wins. some of those highlights. Let's go to the highlights here. Well, I don't know how you can pick out highlights from that match. The whole match was highlights.
Here is your winner, the Superstar Youngblood, Frank.
Wow, he just never got out of the starting gate.
What an impressive victory that was.